First, I'd like to welcome our witnesses this evening. Dr. Stone from the Veterans Health Administration. Dr. Avia Olley from the National Institutes of Health. Dr. McHugh from the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration. Today's hearing will be the first of many this meeting will hold as it begins the critical work to address veteran suicide. I think we can all agree how important it is to take care of our veterans, which is why I have made ending veteran suicide my number one priority. Sadly, America is facing a national public health crisis that demands urgency in Congress, the administration, medical and clinical professionals, veteran service organizations, and veterans themselves. This morning, we lost another veteran to suicide at Virginia Hospital. 2 weeks ago, three veterans committed suicide on VA property in just 5 days. Seven veterans have ended their lives on VA campuses this year. It's clear we are not doing enough to support veterans in crisis. While these incidents may be alarming, they do not tell the full story of veteran suicide in our country. It is harmful to veterans and overly simplistic solely to blame VA for these tragedies. We must come together as a nation to address this crisis. Too many Americans have been personally touched by this troubling trend. For me, it was my own uncle, a Vietnam veteran, who died by suicide. I still remember the day that I came home in September when I was 10 years old to find out that my uncle Sabo, a Vietnam war veteran, had taken his own life, and he lived across the street from my own family. His suicide still haunts me all the time to this day. Each day, 20 veterans, service members, reservists, and members of the National Guard die by suicide.